Everybody, been a while since I've done a gameplay video, so I thought I would start one off here with the Secret World, which I have not done in a while. And I came back to this because, say recently, but it did go from the subscription base to buy it, and then you have access to the whole game, and then they have a cash shop. And it's been that way for a few months. I don't know exactly when that happened, but it's been long enough that they've gone a few months under this model, and they say it's working out great for them. So I thought I would hop back in. I just remember, if you dig back to some of my really old videos, I did some of the closed beta and open beta weekend testing for The Secret World, and really liked it. And people asked me if I had planned to keep on playing it when it went out live. I said no, even though I liked it. And they said, why? And I say, because it's subscription-based at the time. And, you know, there's just so many games. You can't have too many subscription-based games going on. And I think I already had something going on at the time. And I think Star Wars The Old Republic, I think I had. But, you know, I just didn't want to have too many. So, hop back in. Really, really glad I have. The first time I played it, I didn't quite get it. You know, I didn't quite get all the skill wheels and questing and things, and I ended up just kind of running around and dying a lot and getting lost because I just didn't quite get it. But now I'm really picking it up and enjoying it quite a bit. Some things I really enjoy, just to share before we go running off and see if I get killed, but like the skill wheel, and I don't want to repeat too much that's already out there, but just in case you're not too familiar, what I really enjoy is they do this skill wheel. There's no levels, so you don't have to worry about being level 1, level 2. Instead, you get to focus on creating your character how you want, in essence, picking exactly what skills and abilities you want to train in. So if you want to focus in assault rifles, which is what I want to do, I can just build my skills up through this assault rifle portion of the wheel and eventually master assault rifle. Now, when you do that, as you say learn specific skills, you unlock these skills, there's quite a few skills that you can unlock. The trick, and actually I really like, so maybe not so much a trick, because you see this with Guild Wars too, you have a limited amount of active abilities you can have and a limited amount of passive abilities, so you have to kind of pick what you think are the most important skills that you want to bring with you. So you may have like 1,000 skills at your disposal once it's all said and done, but you just need to focus on a primary amount, which looks like it's like 8. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, 8. I still, personally, I use like maybe 2 or 3 of the 8 I'm allowed. Passives, though, well, actually, I guess that's not a slot. So 7. I have 7 here, 7 passives as well. I just see there's room for 8, so maybe I can unlock one later. But right now I get 7 active, 7 passive. I mean, so you got to plan it out a little bit. Fortunately, I'm low enough in the assault rifle tree that I get to have all the skills I've earned so far. Pretty soon I'm going to start unlocking some things, and I got to start making choices. What do I want? Anyway, it's the skill wheel. Then they have like skills or abilities. Now, these allow you to either be better as an assault rifle user. Generally, what it does is allows you to use or equip higher level gear. So right now, like with skill level 2, I can equip quality level 2 rifles. So if I pick up a quality level 3 rifle here pretty soon, I'd want to put points into that skill level so I could use quality level 3 rifles. And it's the same with talismans and any equipment that you may find or have access to. That's why I haven't really spent these points. There might be a trick to spending and using these points, but I didn't want to like put a bunch of points in something and then end up short when I actually picked up a higher level item. So I'm kind of conserving these points, and you know, maybe someone's got better tips on how to use those points. As far as gear, I'm not quite an expert on maybe the best gear that I've been picking up and equipping. Basically, when I find a new piece of equipment, I compare it with what I have, usually from like a quest reward, and they'll have like 3 items. So I'll look at the 3 items and kind of see which one has the most benefits and fewest penalties to what I'm currently wearing, and I just kind of keep swapping equipment out, and hopefully I'm getting better over time and not hurting myself. I know that there are some YouTube videos that kind of talk about how to equip your person, but I'm just not that clever yet. It's still kind of new. But it's still interesting. I like it. No levels, but your equipment and how you spend your skill points really shape the way your character grows. And there's all kinds of clothing stuff that I'm learning. However, I found in the couple of years it's been out, I don't know if it's my computer or they still have some bugs, but this one I thought was pretty big. She still walks around as if she's holding the rifle on occasion, and so sometimes I have to equip it and unequip it just to get her back to looking normal. So I'm not quite sure if that's me or whatever. But I've got some skills or quests. You only have several missions equipped at a time, usually like 3 side missions, a main, a dungeon mission, and then they have this like the main storyline for the area. So I've just got a few things that I've already got running. So every once in a while, we'll just run something. Right now I'm working on this one here, the Hunger. I've been running around today and dying. Fortunately, I haven't really noticed the death penalty, which I know annoys some people. Some people really like to have death penalties. I'm okay. I'm okay without a death penalty. I die enough that having a death penalty would really set me back. Alright, so apparently I've got to come out here. What am I doing on Priest Island? Let me double check. Follow the blood trail. Let me peek here. Even though this is kind of the active mission I'm following, sometimes when you look at the map, it'll still show activity going on for your other missions. Corpse in the woods suggests a mauling. Must be somewhere down here on my map. My mini map shows some pointers this way. That's what I was trying to figure out is. That's the defeat the captain. I gotta do. Should have one more. There's the defeat the captain one. Something about in woods. This one here, see, that's go to Priest Island. That's something else. What is this? Turn to the toilet mission. Don't worry about that. Blood trail. I'm gonna do that one. I probably picked that up. I had to go look at the mission, see where I picked it up, and go back there and see if I can find the blood trail. This does a pretty darn good job sometimes of showing you where you gotta go. I like that, because, again, I'm not that clever when it comes to these games and figuring coordinates and things, so it's kind of nice to show the little, you know, go here to work on that quest. Blood trail. I'm just not seeing it here. I'm gonna see if the quest tells me where to go back to pick it up. Yeah, that didn't. It didn't help me out too much. Sharing, if I had someone to share it with. Dang, where's it at on the map? The reason I'm doing it is because the missions are rated like medium difficulty, hard, or like very hard, and the Hunger here is on a normal difficulty, so I thought I would do that one. I've been doing a bunch of hard and very hard missions, so I thought I would take one that hopefully was not super, super difficult. Problem is, it's not finding a bloop on the map. So I'm wondering if maybe I can just do defeat the captain here, which is going to have me do a little bit of running, but you get to see how I run past all kinds of stuff. I'm going to change out my active mission here. The hall say follow the blood trail. Well, let's just run here. So I had this one down here, defeat the captain. Got this quest ship that came in. Yeah, I was looking at my mini-map here. It's got this little point. Sometimes I can hover it and it will tell me what it's taking me to, but let's just follow the road. So this is the character I made. This is Crisania. An average investigator of the paranormal who zombies, mostly, which is what I fight here in this particular area, King's Mouth. A nice little fishing community here that's been beset by a fog that's brought in all kinds of creatures and stuff from the sea, and we're trying to figure out exactly where all that's coming from. So there's a lot of backstory to the secret world that is just lore that I have not read. And I know before when I was doing the beta testing, there's definitely some folks that followed it a lot better than I did. And as far as quests, like, I still haven't even tried the investigation quests. I know last time I tried to do one in the beta test, I had a bunch of people that were watching when I played live, and they were busy trying to help me figure out how do I beat these different quests and do things. Yeah, so I've already done that quest. As you play through, you run across these quests. And this is nice. I was wondering what would happen. I did this quest, and then it put a timer on it, and I figured I could repeat it. But what's nice here is it put a check mark telling me I've already done it. I mean, it qualified. I could run it again if I wanted to. You know, nothing like experience for running quests just to build up. But that way I could see, oh, I've already done that. I don't have to do it again. Because since you do have a limited amount of quests that you can, or missions you can hold at any one time, this says here if I selected, I'd have to replace one of my currently active missions, and I really don't want to run that one again. I've done it, so I'm just going to skip past. Dump. Can't find the follow the blood trail one. I think that might be one that what I could do, since I can't find the follow the blood trail just off looking, what I might do is replace that with a different side mission, and then if I ever run across the person who gave me that side mission, I could then, you know, run it again later down the road if I found it again. So this is telling me if I go straight out here, I can defeat the captain. I mean, one thing, early, kind of, this is near the starting area, the enemies aren't so thick. You can kind of move around a little bit. I probably shouldn't oughta go that way, though. I know in some areas, it's just thick with creatures walking around. These quite aren't zombies. No idea. The story, as you read it, it points out that the fog brought stuff. And that's part of the secret world, is figuring out what is causing these things. Very Cthulhu-like, or that TV show Supernatural. It's got stuff going on. So with my assault rifle, I was going like the healer route. So I'm picking up abilities that help me to heal and leech life when I fight, which I thought as a primary solo player might... Oh, I wasn't paying attention. But I was hoping I'd be able to kind of do a better job of keeping myself alive. He had a little white circle on the ground. That meant he was casting an ability. They give you little tells when they're going to do an attack, so it kind of gives you a chance to move out of the way. And what's nice is when they start one of those attacks, they can't just change it midstream, so they're kind of committed to it. That lets you dodge out of the way a little bit. By taking these healing skills, I don't know if my survivability is any much better than if I just went pure DPS and then healed after a fight. But my thought was, if I ever do a group, hopefully I can leech life off of one target at a time, but yeah, it might help me do groups. We'll see. I still seem to die. Here they come. Yeah, I'm not gonna go over every single build I have, but just in general, pretty much, I've got this anima shot that, oops, get out of the way, does a little bit of a life leech, and then I just recently picked up this one on the end, shot of anima, that does kind of like a medium burst of damage, and then a big heal. It lets me shoot him up and heal. So if you notice, though, I'm fighting this thing and my life is staying pretty high. I mean, against a group, my life drops pretty good. That means I gotta kill things quickly and move from creature to creature. But in my mind, the heal definitely increases my odds of surviving. So I run into things that are in my way. I was just thinking, yeah, combat's boring. I watched a video. Hey, imagine that. But there was a gentleman who was talking about what he didn't like about the secret world, and he pretty much said that pointed out that the combat here was pretty dull. And it actually can involve a lot of jumping around. You know, this person was talking about it's not very active, like, say, Guild Wars 2, where you can really maneuver around, or Terra type of combat. The thing is, the way that I play, my fingers rest on, like, the number 1 through 3 key. So my fingers aren't on the normal WASD keys for movement. So I have to use my mouse to steer. Well, the problem with that is I really don't get side strafing and dodging and things in. So like an easy way to get out of their attacks is maybe dodge. I can't really do that. And that's just the way I play. So even though I got a rifle, I just stand there and shoot. So even though they're right on me, I just shoot. So if I had a knife, you know, a sword or something, it'd probably look a lot more interesting to watch the combat. But me, it is what it is. Is that the captain? There's the captain. That was one of my missions here, was to kill the captain. Spitting goop on me. Gross. Oh, there he is. Don't run away, captain. Right, and this is what I was talking about. Even though I can have up to 7 abilities, there's just a handful I actually use. Oh, where are you running? Yeah, this guy will be a lot easier than I thought. And there it is. Now, what I like, though, on these missions, quests, if you will, they have tiers. Like here, it says tier 3 of 18. I just completed, I'm working on, thought it was one of these, I guess it cleared out, I gotta read this book, but basically, you can just, as you complete steps, it completes a tier, and some have, like the main story one has 18 tiers to complete, some of them will have 5, so, some of your missions, they just, is nice, because they kind of progress through the town. You don't have to keep going back to the person to get the next part of the quest. They just advance as you go. And so this one here said defeat the captain, but now read the captain's log. Let's see what it say here. Lucky to be writing this. Can't believe what happened. Wouldn't believe it. That's what Doc Bannerman would say. Shrink's going to be earning his pay when we get home. If we get home. Larry and his boy Derek are clammed up. Joe's real fevered. And this thing, still shining like a flashlight. Look over my shoulder, I swear I still see that fog. Now the fog is a nice recurring theme. I get to go talk to Dr. Bannerman. It's the next part of the main story. Let's kill a few things here on the way out. Oh, I gotta bring my pet out. I got some pre-order stuff. I pre-ordered the game, but I just never got it because I had made a decision at the time just not to do a subscription-based game. I don't call me cheap, but you know, a person can only shell out so much money each month on games, and with a lot of these games, even though they say free to play, they have cash shops if you want to buy little extras. So you still end up spending money. So I would rather just buy stuff in the whatever shop they have. Let me see if I can find my pet, because he's supposed to give me some combat bonuses. Where is my pet? Inventory. Here we go. That's one of my pre-order things. I also had a special ring that I got, and a fancy t-shirt, which I don't think I put on. I don't think I claimed the fancy t-shirt, because I just now am figuring out how I can swap out equipment or gear. So think about, let's go to the shop and get her fancy shirt, because I did figure out how to swap gear out. So I went to the item store. What I like too is the item store isn't beating you in the face like the other Funcom game, Funcom Conan. If you want the shop, it's there, but they don't have it like plastered all over the screen. I might claim items here. T-shirt. Time accelerator. I think I only had one. That was an XP bonus. I'm not going to worry about it. But hit shirt. Confirm purchase. So now I have a t-shirt somewhere. Oh, maybe it's in my list of clothing. There it is. Maybe. Chest. There it is. Pre-order t-shirt. Where? And then, even though I like my coat, I'm thinking, let's go coatless here for a little bit. They have a very good clothing system, I had to admit. Put it to the right. A little squid monster thing. Cool, my little Cthulhu shirt guy. Anyhow, I'll shirt it up, and I got my pet. Let's do it. In fact, let's just kill this thing to see what the pet does. Oh. Thanks. Pet. Oh, I didn't move out of the circle. Oh, there's my pet. I don't think he's actually doing anything. I think he said he just granted some combat bonuses, so the pet doesn't do anything active. It just looks cool. Oh, he's gonna get me again. I was hoping to kill him before his skill procced. Hello? Yeah, I won't go into all the crafting and stuff. If I do stuff, you'll see it as I do it. But for now, we're gonna go back and talk to Dr. Bannerman. See what's next. I have a feeling I'm just gonna end up dragging all these things along. Just get me a train of stuff. As I walk through here, I'll probably pick up all these groups of zombies along the way. Oh, yep, there they are. Come on, puppy. I mean, at some point, they do stop chasing you. So that is a viable option. Sometimes it's okay to just run. I know I've done that, trying to find the sweet spot of a mission to trigger something, and just surrounded by things. So I just run through the mission update circle until I trigger the update, and then I figure out once I... Because what they do is they put a big old circle on the map, and they say whatever update you need is within this circle. Well, sometimes you just gotta run the circle, trigger the update, so you know, okay, here's where the spot is, and then later I can figure out how to get back to that specific spot. So just run. I need more hit points. Chasing me. It's the dog. This is the starting city area. As a matter of fact, you come through that gate right there. When you start, there's a little forest area, kind of the tutorial area, and the tutorial area feeds right into the main area. This whole game is broken down into instances, which, I mean, it works. I know people like a nice, big, open, persistent world. For them, they don't have an open, persistent world, but it works in their style. Works in their style. What happens when we talk to Dr. Bannerman. I'm assuming that was Dr. Bannerman.
The Lady Margaret was a traumatic experience for everyone on board. They were changed men when they came back. I visited with all of them in the days following their return.
Now, even though I did a little bit more on the mission, it's still Tier 4. I mean, this is like the big overall mission for this entire zone, so I can honestly see how this is going to have multiple parts to each tier, and then there's, you know, 18 tiers until, I believe, till you clear out Kingsmouth Town and this whole section. And I haven't really explored everything yet. I still have some places up here. And each of these folks have their own missions that progress the story. So you really want to visit these main folks. And then throughout, there's just all kinds of side missions that you can pick up. So, you know, I like that. It gives you a lot to do. So you can either skip side missions or do them and maybe get extra experience and equipment, you know, just like a lot of games. Or you can focus on just talking and clearing out all these folks, what they have to do, and then work your main storyline and move out onto the next map. Lots of flexibility. Let's just go see what happens here at Dr. Bannerman's clinic. Yeah, see, like, I've already come and done their missions, so the timer's run out, and it looks like, I mean, I could run it again if I wanted to. Not that I was a big fan of it the first time, but that's cool. I didn't know you could do that from the beta. I never really got that far. But if there was a particular mission that you enjoyed running, or maybe you had a friend that got the game later, you might be timed out enough that you could come down and run that same mission again with your friend. You know, the rewards might not be as good as the first time you came through, but that's kind of cool. Like, I've done that one. Incomplete report. Here's the apothecary. Not apothecary, but his clinic. Instance. There's a couple places on here you can go into, like the fire department. It's not an instance, but here's an instance. So, even though from the outside the place looks small, because it's an instance, it could be huge for all I know. Coco time while instances load. Examine his files. Now, I don't know if there's anything scary in here. This is trashed. Now I gotta find the files and get ready to start shooting. Broken framed photo. Knight Helen and I met under the fireworks, set to my favorite composer. Computer. Case database. Oh no. I didn't ask for a password from the guy. Hint. To view the alternative password. Hint. Music of the Seasons. Okay. So composer. Seasons. I'm wondering, is that Vivaldi? I wonder if I have to type Vivaldi. See, that's almost like a, in fact, I'll show you here. I'm only taking a guess because I thought Vivaldi did, like, seasons or something. Oh, I gotta get back there. Hold on. Vivaldi. Alright, so that's a lucky guess. Just because I looked at the frame, gotta put the clues together. They actually have in here investigation missions, so I'm not very good at those. Maybe I should go back and revisit them, but it involves you reading clues like that, and then you can search the internet, and what's cool is they actually have, was it this key? I can't pull it up here while I'm in the computer mode, but they actually have where you can pull up like an internet. It's almost like assuming that you have an iPad or something with you, and you can just access Google. It even says you're going to pull up Google to look these clues up, so that's kind of neat. So if I wasn't quite sure which composer did music about the seasons, I could go to Google and kind of type that in and just actually research off the internet to find the answer. Just don't ask me how I knew, but I took a guess, Vivaldi, for that one, and I guess that worked. But look in here, choose a case to proceed. Oh, Lady Margaret incident. I probably should read all of them, but that's kind of the what they wanted here. Derek, Lawrence, Derek, Reed, business address, Joe Slater, home address. They came to me after Lady Margaret limped back to the harbor. All of them needed help, so I arranged separate interviews. It's too early to tell, but something clearly happened on that ship. So I could read the notes for that guy or that guy. What's my next? Find Derek Creed. Find Lawrence Creed. Type here. Ooh. Type there. So I can look at case notes. Derek suffers from severe headaches and a keen sense of paranoia. The similarities with Joe Slater and Lawrence Creed are alarming. It seems the symptoms develop at uneven rates, but I fear everyone on the boat might be affected with this, whatever it is. That's nice. Anyway. Let's see if I can go up. I just want to be paranoid. There's been a few times in the game where you do something and just innocently trigger a pop-out moment. It's like, oh, I gotta start shooting at stuff and get my hands on the keyboard. So part of me is expecting, you know, something to pop out as soon as I finish reading the files, but my luck, something will pop out when I exit the building. Yes, let's go. Now, if I go look for these guys, since they all have symptoms and stuff, I bet they're probably already dead and zombified, and I gotta go kill their zombie forms or something. You know, and just like a lot of games, I'll be running through the woods, and I come across a creature with a name. I'm like, oh, that's a funny name. Kill it. And sure enough, later down the road, I find a mission that says, oh, hey, go kill that creature. I already killed it once, but I guess zombies don't die. I'm just gonna... Oh, hello. Yeah. I do like their combat music. If you ever have a chance to just kind of really listen to the music, they have a couple different songs they play, and it's pretty good. There's this one, just sounds like something out of the 70s with these weird little sound effects going in. Alright, so none of the people I need are here. I'm just gonna camp out here. Where's my dog? I guess my dog only lasts a certain amount of time. Oh, I guess I can call him back later, but I'm gonna camp out here. We'll do more Secret World. I'm not gonna do a complete, you know, from beginning to end kind of playthrough thing. I'll pop in every now and then, show you what I'm doing with the Secret World. But I definitely would recommend checking it out. $30. I'm sure at some point it'll be on sale even more, but I picked it up for $30. Thank you, honey. But it definitely gave me a chance to come back and check it out. Now, I will admit, I didn't get very far the first time through. I'm definitely a lot further than before. However, this plays almost exactly like what I saw the first time through. So, no way I could tell you what has changed from beta till now based on how far I've gotten in the game. Not a clue. Not a clue to the engine or anything else. The only thing that looks kind of new to me that I don't remember before was this auxiliary wheel with like a whip and a chainsaw. That I think is new. Well, new to me. I don't remember that being in beta. If it was in beta, I totally missed it. The graphics still look pretty good. I had to admit, like, I'm doing DirectX 11, and I had to put everything on medium. I put the textures on high, just because, as much as I love her, the old machine here just wasn't running it anywhere decent with much higher settings. It does seem, though, that after the game is loaded in the area better, it has smoothed out quite a bit, so I might experiment cranking the graphics back up just to see how it looks. But the game looks pretty good running on medium. You know, no complaints. Off the top of my head, you know, there's really nothing much to share. I know that if you do go watch the YouTube, you'll see people that have progressed much, much further up. This is near the beginning, so, you know, when you watch me play, you'll just be kind of watching from the start. Not from character creation. Again, the basic stuff you can find, but this is kind of near the beginning. So we'll have some fun with this together. Of course, there'll be times I play when I'm not recording it, so I'll do little recaps between here and there. But so many more games to share, so many more things to do. So for now, though, we'll just go ahead and sign off for now so I can finish my cocoa and get ready for bed. So see y'all later. All right, have a good one. Maybe if I can end it. And there we go.